Hello, hello, hello. I hope you enjoyed the previous episode. We actually expanded on East Frisia. I'm going to change my icon as, but we pretty much took East Frisia. We give Spelunk us the top to Bavaria, not Bavaria, Brandenburg. Everybody hates us, and what allies I did have to become emperor are slowly diminishing. And the emperor is probably gonna kill me. Because if I look at aggressive expansion, pretty much, yeah, as you can see, it's they've got me as a rival, so no wonder they hit me. But aggressive expansion, 32. A lot of people hit me, but it's all green in some areas, so. I might actually want to go to war again with Hungria, because. Yeah, we got that many allies. I'm thinking I might be able to drag my allies into a final war before they break away. He's on military tech 5, same as me, so we'll both be on equal footing, but if that was the case, see Brandenburg, we just got a route marriage with them. They didn't want to be allies with us, but they did break away from us. Have more of a chance of becoming of the Burgundian inheritance. It's still going to be between a succession war between Brittany and me, so prestige is non-existent. It's alright to a degree. I'm not gonna upgrade my allies, should I? Because they'll pay more money towards me. Yeah, it's my guts. I understand where he's coming from. He's not in the Empire, so. And if I adopt him, I can add him inside the Empire, which gives me a bit more boost if I can Emperor. And on top of that, if I start taking over Hungary, I can start adding that into the Empire, which gives me more to add with these rulings. Pretty much I need to get to from now on, so that everybody comes a battle. So Stuart's still in Scotland. Let's have a look. Yeah, they are. Mary Stuart. He's crazy that he's pretty much trying to improve relationship with him. Unless if I improve it, I can adapt him into my kingdom. Also, I should start adapting that Salvinia into my kingdom. Forget Burgundia because they can't be allies with me just yet. Running behind in demo attack, so we then only got 5 instead. Let's see, yeah. It would be 6. I'll take the corruption. It just increases. I think I'm gonna get inflation going when he actually pops up. Not gonna get national unrest because I'm not got really that many kicking off at the moment. Just gonna get prestige. Let's have that prestige. 20 prestige with prestige advisor is pretty good. Gonna squeeze as much relationship onto this as possible.
what we do.
Pretty good, yeah. Really keeping my allies. We're gonna vote for them. I see my lad to one of his rivals, which he doesn't like, but I hate random move so much, this guy. Brandenburg's getting attacked. And he's not calling me in. Like I said, prestige is my main concern in this game. Because relationships start if my prestige hits over 50, it's a fall down. Start getting more power projection on top of that. Saxony on Jaime, but how many manpower does he actually have? Got 17. Damn, is it? How much? 17,000? Infantry, 9,000 cavalry. Got 28. He's got 428. I think he actually has hit his force limit. Let's see, my force limit is 20, 14. Remember right there. Yeah, four of them are. Which might save me a bit money. We keep them mercenaries in the armor. There's one. And absorb him into my kingdom. I'm fine with that. Annex him, but then it gets me Poland right next to me. got so many clans that it's a push. Everything I want to push is in the Empire. Whereas France would attack Burgundia. Because, yeah, they've been pushed out to Christianity. Pop me boost. Everybody's gonna vote for the Austrians because I'm a little bi, apparently. I'm 4 years old, I'm a regent. Incorporating my former vassal Sardinia into my kingdom. I'm gonna leave you there, and hopefully you will watch the next episode. I will say goodbye and good evening.